They don't get much bigger than Britney Spears.
In the zone.
This is Britney Spears.
Britney is back, if she ever really went away.
Britney.
And if the insanity is any indication.
Britney, I love you.
I can't wait for the new Britney Spears album.
She hasn't missed a beat.
She looks great.
Britney's hot.
She's looking out of control hot and appears more in control than ever. But is she really? In the next half hour, MTV News gets inside the head of the real Britney Spears. Turns out this pop superstar, so composed on stage, still can feel like a dork.
I do not have a cool bone in my body.
She may be an icon to young girls, but that doesn't mean she has all the answers.
I have tons of insecurities.
And that amazing body makes her every guy's fantasy. But when it comes to boys, Britney can still freeze up.
I need to learn some moves.
And as for Justin, don't think we won't go there. Britney opens up about the infamous Cry Me a River video.
I just gotta know what your reaction was.
Everyone wants a piece of her, and we've got her. We ask the tough questions.
Did you feel like there's just not a place for me anymore?
And get some surprising answers.
Ah, that's horrible!
As once again, all eyes are definitely on Britney Spears. The last time all eyes were on Britney Spears was with the 2001 release of her last record, followed by her first starring movie role. Shortly afterwards, she announced she was taking a six-month break. What happened to the break?
All right, so, took a little bit of time off.
Mm-hmm. Not a whole lot of time. I could call 3 weeks off.
I know, right? It's like a vacation.
I've been recording. Yeah. More like, yeah, I haven't really been off. I've just been recording this whole time.
You know, when normal people, well, not even normal people, but when other artists say, I'm just going to go ahead and go on vacation, take a little time myself, people are like, well, great. You know, and they just move on to another headline. With you, it almost felt like there were even more cameras. Like, they were like, now we don't know where she's going to be. Let's get 50 more people out there to follow her.
Britney, can I just get one shot?
One shot? We're in a hurry, man. You got to be quick if you want to get me.
That's true, though. I said I was going to take time off, and I was like, why are all these cameras still around? What's going on? It was even more. So I think my mistake was in just announcing I was going to take a break. So seriously, what I want to do, I think would be a lot of fun, is when they come up and all the cameras are in your faces and the video cameras, I want to get like a play water gun and just squirt the shit out of them. I know that sounds really stupid, but that would make me feel so good just to like go and just get them, you know? I don't know. But hey, that would give me even more press. So, you know, you lose either way.
All right, so we're gonna put these rumors to rest.
One word or one sentence, whatever.
Okay.
All right, Colin Farrell. What's the first thing that pops into your head when you think?
I don't know. He's cute. And
he's not cute, okay? My puppy's cute.
He's very hot. There's just something so refreshing. Like, he does not care about what people think, and he's just like, at least, I don't know.
Fred Durst.
Next question.
Okay, great. Cigarettes.
Writing a song, process, creative mode, meditation, you know, but it's not healthy when you're trying to move about. But in a recording studio, I love cigarettes. But it's the truth. But don't do it all the time.
When I saw that video.
What video?
The video.
I'm scared.
Cry me a
river.
I just gotta know what your reaction was to that video, seeing it for the very first time. Do you remember that?
I was a little puzzled. Like, I was kind of like a little thrown off a little bit. But, you know, I don't judge anybody because that's what he had to do to go through what he had to do. I mean, I probably wouldn't have handled it that way. But, you know, guys, egos, da-da-da-da-da, you know, whatever. But
there's a lot in that da-da-da-da-da, by the way.
Yeah, exactly. But, it was a little, it was kind of weird.
Were you more puzzled or were you more like, I'm going to get on the phone and I'm going to tell someone off?
I didn't do that.
Yeah.
I didn't, like, I was just kind of in shock mode a little bit. Yeah. A little weird.
Well, you know what? I like that you took the high road.
Without my wings, I feel so small. I guess I need you, baby. And every time I see you in my dreams, I see your face. It's haunting me.
Are you as an artist more inspired by love or by heartbreak?
Both. I think love makes you feel like you can do anything. No matter what's going on, like you just feel like you can conquer the world. But then I think some of the most touching songs, the songs that really get you here in your heart, are some of the songs from Heartbreak. And everyone really feels that because they hear it in your voice and you can really tell.
You also talked for the first time this past year about your first time.
Sometimes a girl just needs one.
And I need you. How has that changed you as a woman?
I think that when you experience something that special and something so sacred, it's like so much more emotion goes into it. That, I mean, I really thought that I was going to marry the person I was, you know what I mean? Like at that state that I was in at that time, you know, I thought I was going to be with the person of my mother, so that's why I did it. But I think that we were both really young, mm-hmm. you know, very, very young. And both, I mean, he's a great guy. He's an extremely great guy. But I mean, I think everything happens for a reason. And who knows, things would probably have been totally different if we're older, you know? But I think the stage of our lives, it was meant to be for us to experience different people and experience different things.
This past year, I hear, I don't know if it's right, that you had a lot of firsts. Do you remember something that you did on your own for the first time?
I know this sounds really cheesy and not a big deal to most people, but like going downstairs by myself and getting a cab and just going by myself to like go visit a friend or, you know, I don't know, that sounds like such the normal thing to do, but for me it's like it's kind of like a, because I'm so used to like entourage and people around me and stuff. And at night I've been trying to make the time to like, if in like in New York or whatever, at night I just go walk on the streets by myself without telling anyone. It's like a really cool feeling and no one's out there. And I have like a lot of people do stuff for me. So when you turn 21, it is kind of like, okay, I'm going to go to this person's hotel tonight and I'm going to go in and check in myself and I'm going to do it. And it's going to be, you know what I mean? It's a cool feeling. I like that.
Do you feel that even just from a year ago, that you're almost a different person?
I think my biggest growth has been this year. Out of everything, this has definitely been the biggest growth year for me. Like, not that I'm a different person, but just, I don't know, you feel a difference, you know, just a little difference on the inside.
Did you feel that in any time during when you were recording this album and when you were taking time off, did you feel like, wow, what if I come back and there's just not a place for me anymore?
Ah, that's horrible!
No, but you know what I mean? Like, that's such a natural reaction, you know, to have.
You know, I did kind of go there sometimes, but it's like, I really needed to, it was either, you know, go in right away and do an album that I wasn't proud of and come out and be completely poop, or take my time and do something that I really believed in and take that chance. So I think it's better off this way.
Have you ever had a guy not know who you are?
You know what? I need to adventure out more.
A lot of people are saying that this album is overtly sexual.
I should have known this is gonna come when I freaking recorded this song.
After the teen pop wave of 99, a boom that produced a crop of stars who gave new meaning to early retirement, Britney Spears shows no signs of faltering.
Go Britney, go Britney, go!
With more than 50 million sold worldwide of her first three records, the release of her fourth album will be the real test, but there's no denying that she's still marketing magic. Want a headline-grabbing VMA performance? Book Britney. Want to boost those newsstand sales? You know who to put on the cover. There's books, a movie, a video game, you name it, it probably exists. And yet behind the PR machine known as Britney, there's still a young woman who's not yet 22. It's easy to forget until you sit down with her one-on-one.
Do you ever feel like you're leading two lives, that there's two of you?
Well, I think that it's like, you know, what actresses and actresses, it's about being a performer and an entertainer. When you get on stage, like when you're a little girl, you know, and you get on your bed and you're like, I'm Shira right now, you know, and it's like that feeling of letting go and letting God take over and expressing yourself. But then I do get off stage and then I come to me and I'm very like, hi. And I get around people that I don't know. I think they're surprised sometimes because they think I'm going to be like this star girl or whatever, but I'm completely opposite. Yeah, I'm very like shy at first.
It's so easy to assume that because you're young and successful and you're Britney Spears. Exactly. That you've got no insecurities.
Oh, I have tons of insecurities. Like
what?
Like, you know, like if you like someone and you don't know exactly what to say, and they're like saying like all these brilliant things, and they're coming, you know, and they just, you're like, mm-hmm. You know, I had those moments completely like everybody else. Oh my gosh, yes. It's really disturbing.
I think it's so hysterical that you even mention that, because I'm sure guys watching this are like, okay, what guy would ever turn down A, Britney Spears, or B, not be like, marry me now? Or it's not like that.
No.
I don't believe you.
But it's not. Like, I mean, they're really nice and it's very cool.
Yeah.
But I like, if they're like that, then I'm not. I don't like them, you know what I mean? But the people that I do, like if I hang out with a guy or whatever, I totally have those moments. But no, they're not really like that. They're not like that.
I'm a sexy girl. I'm a nice girl.
Do you have Britney moves? Are you like, do you have like these signature? Because, okay, I know you're
gonna... I need to learn some moves. I do not have a cool bone in my body. I don't really have all the pickup line things. And like, you know how some guys just know and they have those? I don't have that. No.
Have you ever had a guy not know who you are?
You know what? I need to adventure out more, because I've never just gone up to a guy at a club and started like, I haven't. What is wrong with
me? Girl, you are 21.
I know. But usually, like, it'll start, the people that I associate myself with, like, it's kind of through business a little bit, and we'll go, it's like, it's very weird for me just to go up to somebody at a club and be like, oh, hi, what's up? How you doing? You know, like, that's not me.
When you're out and you're having fun and you see a guy across the room, then what do you do? Nothing?
I don't say anything. I just go.
Come on!
And I just go to him and start dancing with him.
Oh.
I'll do that. I'll dance. But I don't really.
What if he's not a good dancer?
I'll make him a good dancer. I'll just sit in there and just kind of, I don't know.
Oh, I've done that before. I'm embarrassed. Okay. Did it work?
Huh?
Did it work?
A little bit.
Monogamy is the way to go. Just put your lips together and blow.
A lot of people are saying that this album is, oh, it's so racy, it's so overtly sexual.
Well, there's three songs that are kind of sexy, but other than that, I mean, there's...
Like Breathe On Me.
Breathe On Me, and it's not even talking about that, it's talking about breathing on me. So there's Breathe On Me, and there's Touch of My Hand, which is probably the most sexual song on the album.
Well, speaking of Touch of My Hand,
yes,
I heard the song and there were things in there, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I like myself or something to that effect in the most precious way.
But the thing is, it's not. It's such a touchy subject. Oh my goodness.
Why is it a touchy subject?
I should have known this was gonna come when I freaking recorded this song.
Of course you should have.
Oh, because now when I talk about it, I can totally go in the studio and sing it. But when I'm right here and I like get really weird and bashful about the whole thing.
I'm not ashamed of the things that I dream. I found myself flirting with the verge of obscene.
I think it's a healthy thing. I think it's, you know, and it's not talking about going out and exploiting yourself with different men or anything. I think it's a positive thing, and I think it's reality, and if you try to shut that out, then that's bad. So I think touching my hand, indulging in yourself.
I like that dramatic pause.
It's a good thing. So, yes.
Baby, can't you see I'm calling a guy like you should wear a war.
you write songs that push that envelope? Do you find that empowering?
Well, I think it's about pushing the envelope. I think it's like when you really go through things yourself and like you really feel them, like it's gonna come out sooner or later. It's an exhilarating to express yourself and to get those things out there that you want to say. You know, I think it is empowering.
What's the first thing that comes to your mind when people are asking you about that kiss with Madonna?
I'm surprised to even hear that you have dark moments.
Oh, yeah.
Britney's new album, In the Zone, plants sex firmly in the driver's seat. And when you think sex and pop music, one other name comes to mind. Madonna. Though 20 years apart, the similarities are there. From the superficial, both blonde, sexy, great dancers, eye for the guys, to the more profound. How to win critical respect while pleasing crowds, pushing buttons, and living life in a fishbowl, and thriving. It remains to be seen whether Britney will ever have the kind of cultural impact that Madonna's had.
Hey, Britney.
But recently, the two have joined forces in a cross-generational pop synergy that's mutually beneficial. It also made for a pretty hot kiss.
What's the first thing that comes to your mind when people are asking you about that kiss with Madonna?
Everyone wants to know about that damn kiss.
I really don't understand the big deal. And the big deal, like, with me and Madonna kissing, hasn't America seen two girls kiss before?
She touched my hair and moved around, and she was going like this, so I was like, just doing what she was doing, because I was so nervous. I was like, I've never kissed a girl before. So it was kind of like, it was kind of cool. Yeah. I kind of liked it. I don't know, but not that I would go around kissing girls, but it was like, it was a cool thing. It's Madonna, you know?
I think all girls all across America are going, and if Madonna kissed me, I'd be cool with that, too.
Exactly.
Did she give you any really good advice, or what did she teach you?
She's introduced me to a lot of new things. She's a true artist, and the fact that she does what she likes and she expresses herself in such the truest form. Just being around her is such an inspiration, because not only that, but the way she carries herself with her, you know, her family and her kids, her priorities, and the way, you know, she gives, like, you see that and you're like, oh, you can do that too.
She's also a believer in, what is it, Kabbalah?
Yeah.
Have you explored that, or
I'm not completely real as deep in it as most people yet, but it's something that, like, once you start, it's very intriguing and you want to know more and more about it. So I'm at the beginning phases right now. It's just really weird from being a Baptist and being so about religion all my life to, like, turning to something completely different. It's like, it's kind of weird, but I like it, you know? It's just like, I'm searching.
Because you have a schedule you have and the life you have and you're traveling so much, can it be lonely?
Yeah, it can be extremely lonely sometimes. Yeah. Like, I have a great group of people that travel with me, like, you know, my sister Felicia and stuff like that, and I think it's really important to have them around. But there are those moments where you're like, yeah, you get like that. But that's when I usually write my journal. I'm kind of a private person anyways. Like, I love what I do, but I kind of like being alone. Yeah. It may sound kind of weird, but I like spending time with myself.
But is there a difference between alone and lonely?
I don't think I've ever felt like extremely, I mean, maybe a year ago, I had a part of me that felt really lonely. When I'm really kind of just like in a lull state, when I'm kind of dark sometimes, that's when my best creative stuff comes out. Yeah, like if I'm kind of in a dark moment, that's when all of the best stuff comes out for me.
So. I'm surprised to even hear that you have dark moments.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I have plenty of those moments, but now I feel more alone than lonely. Yeah.
Are you happy now?
Yeah, I am happy. I think right now I'm going through, like, such a new phase in my life. Everything's coming out, and I'm just, like, adjusting to everything, and it's very new and exciting, and I don't know what's going on, but it's cool, you know? It's, like, it's a cool feeling right now. Hey, baby, we can dance all night long.
Come over here, I got something to show ya. Sexy lady, I'd rather see you bare your soul.